It's time for another build on the workshop, this time from popular requests in the comments section. Yes, I read the comments. I don't get a chance to reply to every single one, but I do read through them all. We are going to be building up the 1951 Chevy Fleetline in 1/25th scale from AMT. This is a 2-in-1, build it stock or custom. It's got a lot of cool features in there. It's also got something included in this kit that I personally have never seen included in a model kit before. So we will start taking a look at the parts molded in white styrene. We've got our front and back seats here. Till the fronts are divided a little bit. We've got nice crisp lines here, so we should be able to two-tone the seats without much of a fight. We've got the deck lid here. We've got our door panels again, which have nice strong lines in them and texture, so we should be able to do the two-tone pattern that our people are used to on these doors. Of course, being your model, if you want to do it all as a retro modern or whatever you want to do with it, that's what you should do. We've got the sweet little stove bolt six, the inline six, the blue flame on here. We've got a separate transmission, engine block. Cylinder heads are all separate. They've even got molded in detail and all that there. We've got our nice exhaust system, manifold, intake, distributor, fan, air cleaner. I mean, for being an older kit, it sure got a lot of cool little parts on there, a lot of detail stuff we can work on. On this one here, we've got our other custom exhaust system. This would be the factory exhaust system. We've got our steering column. Be careful. We've got our little switches there. We've got our 6-volt battery, radiator support, firewall, interior with carpet texture molded in. This is actually the front of the interior. This would be the rear. Underneath, you can see it's got molding on there. On our firewall is nicely detailed. Remember, there wasn't a lot going on in 1951 under the hood. Got our frame and rear of the car with our fuel tank molded in. Let you see how that front suspension is going to mount up. These tabs here will be removed. Inner fenders with molded in detail. Got our steelies, steering wheel, springs, spindles, raised and lowered, or raised and stock, shock absorbers. On this tree here, we've got our nice hood. I hate when they do that right in the front. Wonder who designs these mold back in the day. Got our pedals here, gas pedal. Underneath the front rear of the chassis, little frame rails, bumper mounts, front suspension, seat back for that front seat. Yeah, that drives me nuts. They could have put it here, and I don't know if they put it right in the front where you're going to notice it the most. Isn't that silly? Back in the day when they were hand carving those molds, I don't think they thought of some of that stuff. Got our roll pans, got custom exhaust here, carburation and intake. And the final individual tree, we've got skirts, dashboard, excellent detail on the dash, wheel backs, the rest of the steelies. We've got our differential parts here, and springs, steering, and the 51 Chevy Fleetline body, the classic fastback of its day. Beautifully strong molds, nice texture on everything. All of this down here, this rear quarter panel fender skirt there, that's all chrome on the real one, unless you want to customize yours. Make sure you're very careful about that windshield divider, windshield support. Part of this is already loose, which is awesome because we have to cut that off anyways. Got our headlight buckets. Door handles molded in, nice strong trim all the way around. Got our trunk panel. Tail light will need just a little tiny bit of cleanup back there. Body's looking awesome. Let me switch to the other side of the table for the multimedia stuff. We've got our transparent parts, headlights, Windshield and back glass wraps all the way around. I don't mind the one piece, makes it much easier for install, much cleaner when I'm in there. We've got a set of white wall tires. Firestone brand on the other side. They look very nice, got that bias ply tread. But that's not it for you customizers. We've got an entire set of Firestone wide ovals. I love these tires, they put them in a lot of kits. These ones are hollow, the white walls are solid. Those are so nice looking. Could have used that on the kit from Saturday. That would have been cool. We've got a beautiful chrome tree here. We've got our hubcaps, custom wheel. We got bumpers. We got custom grills. We got a custom valve cover. We've got two styles of bumpers, stock and custom on there. Tail lights, headlight buckets. Look at those sweet chrome wheels. So we got all kinds of stuff going on the chrome tree there. Build it up, and the chrome is very well done. On the decal sheet, lots of water slides going on here. Custom logos, but important to all of us are the dash radio gauges. Everything is right there, and they doubled up on it all for us. We've got all of our logos, hood, trunk, headlights, all this kind of stuff, hubcap logos. They give you all the striping, and they list exactly where it should go. License plate options. So yeah, all that cool stuff. And I love when they got the logos, and I love when they double up on them on the sheets with the gauges and everything. Tons of license plates. For those of you that want to decorate other vehicles, we got some AMT cats hidden around the sheet. A lot of nice stuff on there. And something I've personally never seen included in a model kit before, we've got what they call on the box adhesive foil. There's me all funhouse distorted. This is, you peel the back off, you burnish it onto your part, and you don't have to do any Molotow chrome, you don't have to do any painting. It's called bare metal foil in the industrial term, but I'm guessing this is just generic adhesive foil. If it was actual bare metal foil, they might have included the brand name on the box as a selling point, but I've never seen that included in a model kit before. That's pretty cool. So I'm going to start gluing up my 51 Chevy fleet line, and we'll be back in a moment.
Thank you.
From the assembly process, you can tell that this classic beauty is probably going to come out pretty nice. We've got basic detail on here, nothing too extravagant, but it's also a good looking kit. It's going to make for a nicely detailed model. We've got the interior pieces ready to go for their base colors. The back fits in absolutely beautifully to that front seat. We've got our door panels and our rear seat. We'll get them all painted a similar color, and then I can mask off later and detail the other sections of the seating arrangement. The dashboard and the fender skirts will go on and get the same color, and then we will accent the inside of the dashboard with whatever accent color I choose for the door. Get them all to kind of go together that way and line up that way. On this tree here, we've got our radiator hoses, our air cleaner is assembled, and the generator and fan and belt and pulley system all set up. The generator wouldn't be any kind of a chrome or anything. Usually it would just be black, so that's why it's on there at this point. The instruction manuals instructs me to install those discs on the inside of the wheels, and then it also tells me, what I didn't know, was that these two things here are not part of any custom axle assembly. They are air ducts that will lead from the radiator shroud to the engine, or to the firewall, which we have here. We've got our firewall, which I want to do in body color, but I also wanted to make sure those inner fenders and radiator will line up beautifully. So I took the radiator, which has these nice location marks, and I glued that together, and then you saw me align it on the frame. You saw me set it up there to make sure that it was all straight and set to go. Then, just about when it was completely done drying, these marks here coincide with mounts for those fenders that we'll take care of at the end, and I just set it over there and made sure that that all lined up. So now we've got that all set, all dried up. It's nice and strong because the model glue sort of welds it, and we can paint our inner fenders and radiator mount in a dark color and then get our firewall the body color. The interior is set. I did assemble the pedals just because I don't like trying to reach in there later, and they're easy enough to brush black when I get done. We got our interior and that package shelf. I will do the same color as the carpeting. So we've got that all attached, and that locks in super nice so that you get that proper angle on the back window there, like that. So we're not going to have any problems putting that together. The differential and shocks are all assembled. You saw how I did that. We glued the differential together. Then we placed it on the chassis. I attached the shock absorbers and lined them up, let those two parts dry, then removed it completely so that I can paint it up. Steering wheel, I'm using the stock wheel. Gear shift on the right side. Little turn signal indicator. I love those heavy duty switches from back then. Like those old window switches. I have those power switches in my house that go clunk, 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 like the old style switches were. We got the stove bolt all set up with carburation, intake, exhaust on the same side. We got our coil, distributor, even a crankcase breather. We got our starter that's built into the mold, and our stock valve cover. These make into attractive little engines that you could put in any hot rod or anything like that. Nice looking engines. Put it in a pickup truck, put it in a custom build, put it in a go-kart, whatever you want. The chassis also goes together with nary an issue. The rear bumper mounts will be a little tricky to line up. The instructions aren't like super clear, but I just made sure I did some lining up on my own there with the radiator assembly and all that stuff. And then the front suspension, and when we looked at the parts, you saw it just had the large pins there. So that all just drops together, and I use the stock spindles because I don't want it raised or lowered. I want it to sit level on the front. Otherwise, it had the modified ones to rake the nose down a little bit for you, or if you flipped them around, it would raise it up for a gasser. But I want a nice stock. I've never built this car, and I think it looks really cool as this fastback, so I wanted to do it all stock. It's even got the sway bar, the steering linkages, and everything go in there. So nicely detailed. We'll get that all painted up and worked on. That is it. All I did was cut the part out of the body. I did snip the hood off, made it nice and even. We've got these little attachment points, these little hinges. I can hang onto that while I get that painted. And then I scrub the body with Simple Green to make sure that the paint will adhere in the next step. So the next step is to get everything primed, painted with color, and then we'll come back for the detailing section.
Thank you.
As always, at this point, let's take a look at the things I've worked on so far in the detail and painting section. It's going together very well, in fact, better than I thought it would at this point. I expected to have to fight a lot of parts and stuff like that, just, you know, given I think the kit might be a little older or something like that. But so far, so good. Now we've got the headlights in, got the tail lights in. Those are just attached with some gel super glue. I like to use a lot of super glue for my final assemblies, and the gel is a thicker super glue that won't run, and it allows me to attach things like the hood ornament, the headlight bezels, and those tail lights. You saw me do all the chrome work around the vehicle. On this one, I did it with a Molotow pen because I had larger surface areas to play with, and then I used the Molotow on the fender protectors, and that really came out nice. Applied it nice and thick, and then I used the foil that AMT includes in the box to do the rocker protection down there. I've never used bare metal foil before. This doesn't seem like it's bare metal foil. In fact, it doesn't hold its shape like an aluminum foil with adhesive. This is kind of plasticky, and it has a plastic sheen to the top of it, so I'm not sure what they used. It's passable. I don't think it would work very well on the thin trim though, but on the rocker panels it looks nice. So that can work, and then I use the Molotow on everything else to fill it in. Glued the glass in. She looks nice and sweet in that celery color, or very, very light mint. Got the chassis ready to go with that Stovebolt 6. Now, the instruction manuals say to use orange. I Googled it. I saw some that were blue, some that were gray, some that were green-gray, and some that were orange. So it doesn't matter to me what's factory perfect. This could have been dropped in. This car could be sitting in someone's garage in 1982 or 2023, whatever we want to say. So this Stovebolt happens to be orange in this car. Got the exhaust in, got our suspension attached, got some small parts painted, and those wheels look delicious with the Chevy hubcaps on them. Absolutely outstanding. Since the entire wheel section on these is covered, I didn't bother sanding the tires. So these just will sit, but those white walls on there, and they'd look good with the black walls too. They would also look mega tough with the Firestones and just the Steelies or the optional chrome wheels and stuff. It would look pretty tough as a custom rod too. So she is looking nice. She's looking tight. The interior looks great. We got things glued together. I got the little battery in there. We got our radiator and our inner fenders. We got that firewall. That's why I painted the firewall color of the body over black to give us a lot of shadows. And then I just accentuated some black parts on that firewall. The interior is great. Can't believe how well the two-tone turned out with that Insignia white over a white primer. You see it completely hid the green underneath. Got the door panels done up in their two-tone, and then I got the interior and the carpet. The dash, I painted the body color, and then the same Insignia white on the inside. It's very hard to see because it kind of loops in. And then those dash decals are on there, and our color-matched steering wheel. So that's a cool-looking ride. I like the green on the green. This ends up dropping down right over the top, like so. And then we'll squeeze our body in. We'll get our grill in, we'll run our air ducts, and we will install our factory bumpers. I really like these with the bumper guards and that little brush guard on there, so I definitely want to use the factory ones. All that we have to do for decals are the hood and the trunk logos. That's it. I'm going to, instead of the blue Chevy logo here, I'm just going to use a blue marker when I'm done. It'll be a lot faster for me to put that on there. Then I will brush on two coats of that future floor polish you saw me use to attach the headlights, and I'll have the final. A good number of you had asked for this in the comment sections of other videos, so we've got it built up, the 1951 Chevy Fleetline in 1/25th scale. From the folks at AMT via the parent company, Round 2 Models sent this over for a full build review, and I really did enjoy it. We haven't built a car of this style in a while, and we had some fun with it, and it also includes that, what I would say is the adhesive foil. It's not bare metal foil. It's not the brand name. It's not the super thin stuff that's expensive. This is almost felt to me like that aluminum that you would use for ducting. and stuff like that, but still a little more stiff. It felt a little more plasticky. So I do not think it would work well on the main trim, but along the rocker there, it worked absolutely fine. And Med left a part I didn't have to use the Molotow on, but I did use the Molotow chrome pen on everything else, as you saw, including the nice fender guards there, the nice chip guards on the fender. I did those with that. We included the hood ornament. I built the bone stock version. I just think that is a classy looking ride. I did it in this nice, what they call celery green. To me, it looks like a very light mint, like you took mint and added about 50% white or a little bit of yellow to it. Looks pretty awesome. Did the wheels in the same color as that, but I did paint the wheels black first so that they show more shadows. Got the hubcaps in there. We only really used a couple decals for the hood ornament and the trunk ornament, and the dash is where we used it. Tamiya clear on the taillights. We used Pledge floor polish to give it a shine. Glued the glass in with super glue since it was a one large piece. And the car looks awesome. I two-toned the interior, two-toned the dashboard, matched the dash to the paint color. So I don't know if that's factory perfect. I looked up a couple of them, but there's a lot of variations in that stuff. You could really order some differences. And plus, people restore them, but then make their own interior in them and all that stuff. So that's why I like to do stockish and never claim that it's a perfect reproduction. You can see underneath, looks awesome. Every bit the part with that factory exhaust on there. Of course, you do have the aftermarket options under the hood where you can dress up the engine. That Stovbolt 6. Now, the instruction manual says Chevy Orange for that engine in this car, and that's what I used. If your references or if you own one and it's different, that's totally cool. Go ahead and do it that way. But I just grabbed the manual and said, eh, and I went online, saw numerous different pictures of it, and figured I'm just going to follow that one and go with it. The decals that I did use, I used just a smidge of decal solvent, and they sunk right into those badges. So they look totally 3D on there. They look spectacular, and I love them. The grille just pressed in. I used some super glue on either wing. The bumpers went on, and the bumpers reveal where I made a boo-boo. In that spacer between the bumper and the body should be body color, and I ended up doing it black as the chassis. But if you don't know, it's not a big deal. But if you do know, or if you want to make sure that you are factory perfect or going to a model show with it or something, make sure to get that the body color instead of what I did on there. So I had a great time with the kit. It looks good under the hood. It looks good above the hood. It looks good underneath. It just combines to make a really cool looking classic 51 Chevy. They had a lot of style, a lot of rounding to them and all that stuff. So I think it's quite a cool looking cruiser. The trim is prominent enough that it was very easy to do freehand and with some simple masking as I showed in the video. I want to thank all of you for watching. I hope you're having a nice summer, and I will see all of you at the next review.